guys, this is Falcon. And welcome to again another review of the franchise, of course. And this is a Diary of a Wimpy Kid Dog Days. Yeah, the third installment of this movie though. Yeah, for me this is like the last good one in my opinion for me though. I don't think the Long Haul is like the part of it though. It looks more like a reboot from in my opinion because of the different actors, though. I think it looks more like a reboot, but anyway. But this is the third one, though, that I'm reviewing right now, though. I mean, I do like the third one, though, but unfortunately, there's only, like, one downside of it. So, there's only one downside of this movie, though. Just one, though. Not as many, though, as the first one, though, but I will say, in my opinion, I think this one's quite underrated, though. I don't think it was as bad as what people said it was. In case people say it's a bad sequel, though, I don't think the sequel is not as bad as people making out to be. But, well, in case people don't like the movie, in my opinion. I don't know if I've seen your, I haven't seen your reviews and stuff from now, but overall, I still think it was underrated, in my opinion. It's not that bad of a movie, though, but I still liked it regardless, so I honestly think this is a lot better than any of the, any of these movies are better than The Long Haul for me, so. Of course, so Diary of a Wimpy Kid Dog Days, I do enjoy though. I saw this at the theater as well though. This movie came out, what year? 2012, yeah. This movie came out in 2012. I think I was 13 when this came out, and I remember seeing it. And I was in 7th grade when this came out, believe it or not. Yeah, I was in 7th grade when I saw it at the theater though. I was 13. That was my first time being a teenager, so yeah. It's pretty cool though. This is actually the first part as a teenager when I saw it. So it's pretty cool though. So yeah, let's get to the plot of the movie though. The plot of the movie, you know, of course, I do remember the cast though. Well, we'll get to it. And the cast is about, not the cast, the plot is about, you know, we got, of course, our character, Greg Heffley. Yep. I forgot to mention the Roger Rolls when at the beginning of this movie when we got our Greg and her and his family, you know, going to roller skates, you know, accidentally gets on the little kid's cake, you know. But yeah, that was kind of hilarious though. But anyway, now the first part of the third movie, because they went to the pool, of course. It went completely crowded, you know. And Greg was having to get Mandy, their little brother, of course. They pees in the pool, you know, and he gets out of the pool, you know. But now the plot with that, you know, of course, you got him gets to a job, you know, of course, before going to 8th grade. You know, they're in 7th grade. Well, I mean, yeah, they're in 7th grade still. The last day of school in 7th grade, though, before the summertime, and they... So he wants Holly Hills, you know, his friend, you know, he wants Holly to sign her name or her number. Oh, unfortunately, her number wasn't finished on his yearbook. So unfortunately, his picture got the wrong picture. That was him when he was very young, though, instead of being like on a 7th grade picture. I thought it was kind of... Yeah, I kind of feel bad for him, though, but with that, though, but, you know. But, yeah, so. And, he was playing video games for, like, a day or 24, I don't remember how long, though. So he turns the game off, turns the TV off, and holding a football with himself, pretending that he's playing sports. So, but unfortunately, Dad found out he's been playing video games all day. He unplugs everything off, you know, and then Greg, you know, I mean, his dad wants to do everything for Greg, you know. Then their mom, of course, wants to do like a book club, you know. Read books together, of course, And then Greg wants goes hang out, rally, goes to that one place, and to like have like to hang out and stuff, you know. And he pretends that he's got a job, right? Yeah, he pretends lied to his dad, saying that he's got a job when he didn't. So then he plays tennis with Riley and Greg. Both play tennis with Holly and of course Patty. Yeah, Patty started hitting tennis at them, and of course Holly's, you know, teaching Greg how to play tennis, and then Greg tries to get Holly to sign his number, finish signing her number, but fortunately, her stupid, annoying sister interrupts him. You know, interrupts that. Just complains about her the concert of hers being canceled. I'm like, so I mean, really? I mean, okay. I mean, just let your sister sign her friend the number, okay? I mean, gee, that's the one thing I have problems with this movie was Holly's freaking sister, her sister, in this freaking movie. In this movie. I mean, even in high school, his last day in seventh grade in middle school, of course, she interrupted her. Like, what really ticks me off about her that Holly tries telling her that she didn't finish signing the number or name to Greg, and she just says she don't care. Really? You don't care, huh? Okay, what if I'm the person who don't care about, I don't know, this kind of pissed me off about it. I mean, that's the one downside about this movie, though, was her sister, annoying sister, but, I mean, that's a freaking, I didn't mean to do the movie like that, it just ticks me off about it when her, of course, her sister, I don't know, just interrupts her, she did it on purpose, guys, really. I mean, at least Patty, unless she's not as bad as Holly Hill's sister, I mean, I would have liked to see Patty beat the crap out of her older sister, which, thank goodness, I mean, I would love to see that, you know, but anyway, moving on. I mean, I just hated her freaking sister. I just wish I could just beat, I don't want to say. I mean, I wish I could reach out to the TV screen and just do this, like, you know, and just, I don't know. I don't want to get to that, though, but anyway. Now, back to the movie. Now, the next day, their dad bought a dog, and they named Sweetie, their little brother Mandy named Sweetie. And then Roderick accidentally spelled their name Sweetie to Sway, which I thought that was kind of funny. And it was funny that Sweetie got Mandy's blanket. They tried to get the blanket, and then they, of course, they got the meat roast. Of course, they had to clean it up, but it won't do any good, so they didn't eat the meat. But the mom and Roger started eating it like crazy, you know. And then Greg comes over to Riley's house, and, well, first off, they gave him a cell phone, which is a crappy-ass cell phone, and, I mean, all he has to do is call 911 and home. That's it. That's a ridiculous, stupid cell phone. I mean, why not just give him an old iPhone instead, or any button cell phones, you know? I mean, that was around the time when iPhone 4s came out, or I think it was a year after when iPhone 4 came out at the time. I remember that time, but I think it's basically before iPhone 5, you know, but anyway. The game cell phone comes over to Riley's house, and they go to amusement park, and of course they share an ice cream. They have one ice cream. I thought it was kind of funny, though. Three people sharing one ice cream, and then Greg doesn't want it and pretends that he's lactose intolerant, you know, but then and they Riley's promised their parents not to go on scary rides, and you know, Groy did it with him anyway, and they both go on a ride, and you know, and then they disappoint Riley. They went on this amusement park, you know, that ride, you know. And then they both sleep in, and then Greg wants to take that, and they leave emails of them, all of these people. Well, they got all of the emails sent to them. And then Greg, don't know how this phone works. He accidentally called the cops, you know. And the cop shows up and gets down Riley's father, you know, just almost arrested him. So, but no, thankfully not. You know, Greg comes home, you know, and Riley's was scared of, you know, of Greg, scared that he's driving crazy, you know. And then Greg goes to the swimming pool, guys, bathing suit off. Accidentally got his baby suit off from the diving board, and then this girl just throws the baby suit off this wall gate thingy, whatever you can say it. But then he's got on one of those huge tight baby suits, so he got his baby suit back on, and it gets to Roderick, you know. And then another day, and then Greg pretends that he's someone else, you know, and you know he wants there anyway, and then Greg and Riley got along together again, you know, and unfortunately we got Greg, Riley's father, you know, finds out what's this issue, you know, with the prices that he spent, you know, on and all that stuff, you know. And then Frank, which is Greg's father, of course, he finds out about it too. He's really disappointed. He pays them back, you know. They were almost about to go to Spain Union, of course, that place, yeah. Spain Union. And, yeah, so they didn't went there this time, thankfully. They went to a summer camp first, you know. Then they're trying working on tents and stuff. They saw these men or teacher, or I don't know what you call them, these people, talking rumors about them. They started doing traps on, planning doing traps on them, so they're doing it, and then Greg got like a bag of ants to put in their camp, and then what's funny out that they got like a TV and stuff, you know, that hides under the bed, you know, that he accidentally got ants all over him, you know. They went outside of the tent, you know, and then Greg's father sees everything, what the other people had, you know. They finds out they got taped, and then Frank got pissed off at them, you know, and then this one camp dude person, I don't know what you call him, but just got us out, gets the sticky things, honey, you know. Because that I bears on the drawings, but yeah. So then Frank, you know, Greg's father just admitted that Greg's not gonna go to Spain Union. So, but yeah, you know. So the next summer, you know, they Greg, Riley, and Holly both have time together. You know, they went there and eat, you know, and stuff. But that, and that was a pretty satisfying ending for me though, and that's how the way it ended. And what do I think of it? The problems I have with this movie, though, is Holly Hill's older sister. Oh, I forgot to mention that. That Roderick doing his own band in front of her sister, older sister. She gets really ticked, though, and then he started doing the Justin Bieber song. Like a type of parody, you know? And that really ruined her up, which I thought that kind of teach her a lesson, so yeah. That was a really great way to fix the movie for me. So, but yeah, I still think it was an underrated movie. Despite it just got one flawed with it because of her sister complains about her favorite band being canceled. I mean, I mean, really though, I mean, just interrupted her own little sister, a middle sister trying to write her own number to his friend, you know? I mean, it's just complaining about her band being canceled. I'm like, okay, who cares? Okay? I mean, gee, who freaking cares? All right? I mean, gosh, I mean, I don't know, but that's the only downside I had was the movie, though. But I still enjoyed it regardless. I still think it was a decent underrated movie for me, though. But yeah, even the first one, it just got two problems with it, though. But I can let all that go, though. But this time, it's just not like a size rant with it, though. But yeah, I did enjoy Dog Days, though. Despite I have this one problem with it. Oh, let's get into the cast. Hold on. The cast, we got, of course, Zachary Gordon, who plays Greg Heffley. Of course, I thought he did a really great job as Greg Heffley. Even Devin Bostick, I forget, he plays Roderick, their older brother. I think he also appeared in the show 100, which I'm surprised I haven't finished watching that show, though, as much, though, but... Oh, we got Steve Zane, who played their father, you know. Yep, who played their father, you know. Robert Corcoran, who played Rally Jefferson. Oh, Holly Hill's played by Peyton List, which, I mean, there's a bunch of other casts in this movie, which I'm probably not going to get to right now, but overall, I still think this is a really great, or not great, though, but just an underrated, decent movie for me, the third one. Yep. Yeah, I know it's sad to say that the rest of the books never got a movie of it, though, but I do think it's best that, since the older actors got older, though, I think it's better than not to make any of those movies no more. It's safe to keep making the books, so just probably for the better. I think it's better that the books will still go on, instead of just making movies of it, so yeah, probably for the better. Just so it just won't hurt my childhood more, you know, but anyway. Yeah, that's, like I said, that's my review on this movie once again, and, yeah, I'm probably not gonna bother with, Dog Days, The Long Haul. I'm not gonna bother with that, so thank you so much for watching. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and, you know, I'll see you guys later, and I'll see you guys in the next video. I hope you guys, see you guys next time. Peace.